Earthquakes are a very rare phenomenon here in South Korea, but it's becoming increasingly clear that something needs to be done to be better prepared against a force of nature from now on. Oh Jung-hee pinpoints to us the reasons for the sudden seismic activity and what could be in store down the road.
Korea has been traditionally regarded as an earthquake-safe country. A few earthquakes have occurred off the Korean coast, but not many have happened on land. And unlike Japan, which is located where the Eurasian plate and the Pacific plate meet, the Korean Peninsula is relatively far away from this boundary area. But
earthquakes can still occur in Korea even though the country is located within the Eurasian plate, and that's what makes earthquake projection even more difficult. The energy created at the plate boundaries is transferred within the plates and then later released through earthquakes.
According to geology experts, there are roughly 450 active faults within the southern part of the Korean Peninsula, with most of them concentrated in the southeast. Among them, the largest is Yangsan Fault, 170 kilometers long and 1 kilometer wide. Both last year's Gyeongju earthquake of magnitude 5.8 and the recent Pohang earthquake of magnitude 5.4 occurred near this fault. But it's still difficult for the government and academics to accurately pinpoint which fault exactly caused the Pohang earthquake, as there are so many small faults connected to the Yangsan Fault.
We're seeing that the earthquake broke out from a fault that has not yet been observed or reported about.
Some experts have warned that the Pohang earthquake could be a prelude to bigger tremors. Also, Korea's Meteorological Agency has analyzed that an earthquake as strong as magnitude 6.2 could strike the Korean Peninsula. And that's why Korea has to be better prepared for earthquakes and their after effects, like soil liquefaction. Soil liquefaction occurs when a strong enough quake shatters the earth, bringing groundwater up to the surface to mix with the soil above it. This makes it as if the buildings are temporarily floating on water. Geology experts have witnessed soil being liquefied at 100 spots within 2 kilometers of the Pohang earthquake's epicenter.
Japan has implemented a new building practice after experiencing soil liquefaction many times. They build buildings with pillars anchored onto the bedrock deep in earth so that buildings can stay stable even if an earthquake or soil liquefaction occurs.
Korea has experienced major earthquakes 2 years in a row, and there could be more in the future. It's crucial Korea is more aware of the kinds of faults around the country and where they're located, and buildings are designed to withstand earthquakes to ensure people's safety. Oh Jung-hee, Arirang News.